I'm going to tell you my deepest, darkest secret. Are you listening? I've been banned from the local library. I, lover of books, banned from the library, the temple of books. I can't go to the library anymore, and it's happened over a trifle. I met this girl in there. Well, I say met, not formally, saw her from across the room. She was reading a book in the saga section, and I was looking over at her while she pretended to ignore me, and then she licked her finger to turn the page, and I just knew she was up for it. I mean, she was putting out. I nipped down to the bathroom.
Oh?
Dirty mind? Didn't go there for what you think. Didn't spank the Frank. Didn't thump the pump. Didn't buff the banana. It's not what I do. I went there to service that woman. I took my pants off. Like this. And then I went back and showed her exactly what she was clearly gagging for. Her reaction was, well, not what I expected. She closed her eyes, closed the book, and then walked off without saying a word. Weird. When she licked her finger to turn the page, she clearly told me what she wanted, right? So I found her leaving just rather hard to explain. You know, some people just don't know what they want, do they? Or perhaps she left the kettle on and remembered and had to make a dash for it, or something. The library manager gave me a stern talking to after that one, although she was a woman too, and I read in some of her pauses that she was willing to give the two of us a go. She was talking to me in a bit of an embarrassed tone, which I didn't quite get. You know, if you wanted me so much, you should have just said so. And I would have given her the best of me, you know? So the second time, there were these two young women. I'm not going to say girls, although they were quite young, because you're going to think I'm a monster after that. And they were at least 18, if not older. I don't do children. I'm not a pervert. So there were these two young women reading a book in the saga section, if you know what I mean. What is it with women in sagas? You know, they're so boring, they just go on and on and on. You know, that's why men are men and women are women. Because we're different. I don't like sagas. They were sat there, reading the book, together, and then one of them giggled. Then, they read some more, and then giggled again. Now, if that wasn't a signal, I was a bit worried, because I wasn't sure if I could pleasure two women at the same time. Not at the same time, because I don't have to, you know. So that would be physically impossible anyway. No, I mean, I find it difficult to pleasure one and then the other immediately afterwards, because the second one would have seen a friend enjoying it so much, and then she'd be so frustrated. Then I'd go and pleasure her, and then the first one would see her happy, and then she'd add some more, and then I'd go back, and then she'd want some more, and on and on and on. It was just going to be quite a task. Although, with my stamina, I was surely going to be up for it, most likely. And as they decided to give me the signal, I thought I'd show them that I was up for it too, and I might as well. They had the weirdest reaction. They looked at me for a couple of seconds, and then one of them started to giggle. And then the other one followed. And then they were just there, just giggling and giggling and giggling, instead of inviting me back to their place or asking if they could come to mine. I had to cover up after a while, as I was starting to get a bit cold. Figured out what it was afterwards. What they were reading must have been so funny that it kept them giggling even after I showed them my interest. The library manager gave me another stern talking to. For their sake, I'm sure. Don't know why she then banned me from the library, though, and cut my card with a pair of scissors. If she wanted me so much, why ban me? How are we meant to see each other? Now, I tried to ascribe some kind of sexual meaning to the card cutting, but I just couldn't think of anything. I mean, when someone does this... That's not very sexual. I mean, what I did to those two girls was a compliment, right? How else are you meant to show anyone on the street, you know, how you think they're beautiful? Okay, sure, you could bring them chocolates and flowers, but to a complete stranger, that would be a bit extreme. And expensive. If I went up to every single person I liked on the street with flowers and chocolate, I'd need a lot of money. I mean, a lot. That's why I stick to my own kind of appreciation, you know. Do you know what? I actually saw those two girls afterwards again at the local supermarket. You know, I remembered that they liked me because they giggled again when they saw me. You know, which just goes to show that that saga book that they were reading was so funny that it kept them giggling even after a couple of months. I got banned from the local supermarket too. No, not because of the girls. No, their giggling put me off a bit. I mean, how are you meant to have it off with a woman who's just giggling all of the time over that saga book, or with two giggling women? Now, you're going to ask me, why? What is wrong with someone who's giggling during the sacred act of lovemaking? After all, laughter and giggling are signs of expressing pleasure, right? Wrong! There are times to express your pleasure through laughter, and there are times to express your pleasure through moaning. And when you are with a considerate lover like me, who does not make jokes during the sexual act, you are not supposed to laugh. You are supposed to moan with pleasure. So I said no to those two, despite how much they wanted. Yes, I've been banned from the local supermarket. They've lost a good customer, and they've lost it over nothing. I was in the frozen products section. A woman bent over into the freezer, put some ice on her forehead. I just knew, right? I rushed to the bread section, grabbed a hot dog bun, you know the type? Spit down the I went back over to her. She was in the dairy section at this point, which was a good sign that she was also up for it. I put my, you know, into the bun, and I showed it to her. Oh, you know, sometimes I just get so pleased with myself. Seducing woman is more of an art than a science. You have to be creative, you know, always find new ways of expression which fit the situation. For example, someone might say, I would enjoy a good meal. And that's exactly how I approach the supermarket situation. I not only implied that she would enjoy a good meal, but also good sex. She probably wasn't hungry. You know that showing your most intimate parts is mentioned in some of the oldest history books. Herodotus wrote about it. There were these men and women going to festivals, and everywhere they stopped by, they showed the villagers their, you know. So, if what I said, what I did, was so chronicled and revered, then why did my mum have such a problem with it? She made such a fuss when she found out about it. I mean, sure, that's what mothers do. But she told me I should go to a shrink and seek treatment. I don't know why I'd be seeking treatment. I'm not ill. You know, I know I'm an independent adult and I should have shown her where to stick her opinions, but our situation is a little complicated because she provides my accommodation. Oh, no, I don't live with her. No, not that sort of weirdo. No, she just pays the rent for my studio, so I have to listen to what she says from time to time. So I did go and see a shrink. A male, obviously. A woman wouldn't have been able to resist my charms. Cognitive behavioural therapy. He tried to encourage me to justify the unjustifiable actions that I was committing. I mean, I'm absolutely fine, okay? I'm a good citizen, I have a good job, I don't steal, I don't kill, I'm not a noisy neighbour. You know, there's nothing to cure about me. I've not been sexually molested as a child. You know, my family didn't abuse me. I wasn't even bullied at school. Yes, I enjoy sex. Ooh, big surprise. Like every other single person in this room, which is totally normal, like me. Right? So they prescribed to me medication, which was very difficult to fake that I was taking because my mum insisted that I swallow it right in front of her. Selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, that's what I was prescribed. Didn't swallow any of it. Hid it under my tongue, spat it out like the rotten egg it was. Do you want to know how I got cured? I went to the theatre. Let me explain. At this point in time, I was already an experienced lover, and I was ready for action wherever I went. And I was at the theatre, and there was this woman waiting in the corridor. She didn't give me any particular signals, and you know, I wasn't that interested in her, but I decided to give her a chance to enjoy me, you know? Do you know what she did? She lifted up her skirt and showed me a, you know? She was wearing nothing underneath, nothing. A meeting of minds. From then on, I have had a girlfriend. What am I saying, girlfriend? She's more than a girlfriend. She's cured me. Let me show you. See, I'm wearing pants. She's my soulmate. My love, my everything. You know, all that cognitive behavioural therapy, prescription medication, when all I actually needed was a girlfriend. Of course we had sex on that corridor, right as we met. We went at it like two rabbits in heat. She was ready after she lifted up her skirt. I was ready. No pants on, remember. No one was there to catch us in the act. Get it? Because we were in a theatre. It was disappointing. I guess we were the only two late to that performance anyway. But yeah, I've been cured. And I introduced her to my mother, who actually quite liked her. Luckily, my girlfriend is not attracted to my mother, so she didn't show her any of her lovely bits. We have a lot of sex. I mean, it's because we're in love and we're young, but I mean, it's a lot of sex. I mean, obviously we do all the normal stuff still, and the stuff that we missed out on in the past. I'm still banned from the local supermarket, but I don't mind. We're planning a supermarket tour of the Southeast. We're going to have sex in every single one of them. The soft drinks aisle, because I have all these boxes and packs which you can get really creative with to sit on during the sacred act of lovemaking. And it's not as cold as the refrigerated section. We're going to have sex in each and every one of them. We've made a plan, we've made a schedule, and we're going to stick to it. And once we're done with the supermarkets, we're going to move on to the theatres. They're very special to us. After all, that's where we met. So, watch out. When you're leaving, you might get a load of us. See ya. Or rather, you see us.